Do you want to improve your classroom management skills? Do you want to increase student engagement? How about amplifying student success? Then you've come to the right place. Welcome to Things That Work. M for marking papers. This video goes hand in hand with the video G, grading papers. This will actually look at the process I use for marking papers. Now, grading papers is a whole nother subject closely related to this, but not the same. So I encourage you to check out the G video and check out this video. They go together and you will have a complete package then. Color has meaning. You know those cool four color pens? Well, I use four colors when I'm grading. The first color I use is red. Red is what I mark errors with. It is a standard color, and yes, I know there are studies that talk about how red can hurt a child's feelings. My students are tough enough to handle the red, so that's what I use. It's nothing personal, it's just a code. By the way, if you decide to use color coding on your grading, be sure and post a key in your room to what those colors mean. I use green to mark the good things on the paper. Green are, and I also add suggestions that they might could add things better. Green is the go-to color. It's the color that shows action. And then I also go with blue for general comments, overall observations, and that type of thing. And black I use for structural markings, arrows to move sentences, rephrasing ideas. That type of thing is done in black ink. And those cool pens with the four colors, they're great for this. Now, there are also pens that have a gazillion colors in them. So it's kind of up to you how you want to do that. Just be sure your kids understand the key to your grading. Next thing, abbreviations. This also will require you to post a key in the classroom. But abbreviations speed things up. For instance, grading essays. If the wording is awkward, I use AWK, and I use the green pen for a suggestion of how they might clear that up. Which moves us into the third area. So we have these multiple abbreviations all over the paper. Well, we need to be specific when it comes to what the problem is. So in writing the comments in blue, I offer very specific instructions, specific information on what I'm seeing in their paper. So finally, offering solutions. This also comes in blue and sometimes green. So that way the student can see ways to take care of the problems that are on their paper. So this is just how I do it. You can adopt whatever system you would like, but having a system when marking papers will speed up your grading process. Now, I also suggest you check out the video Grades Suck, because remember, grades are incredibly limited. Grades only tell you how well a student did at that moment, on that assignment, that day only. It tells you nothing about the student, tells you nothing about who they are, it tells you nothing about their effort, tells you nothing other than that one thing. Now, can you determine from that one thing whether or not the student is understanding the skills and the knowledge that you sometimes, and if you do multiple assessments and assess throughout the process of learning, then yes, you can. But that one paper, that one assignment, that's not going to tell you a whole lot. So don't rest a whole lot of weight on a single assignment or a single assessment in order to determine how a student is doing. Take a whole picture. So marking papers, that is key. And if the sooner a student gets their paper back to the time they completed the assignment, the more effective those marks will be. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you like it, and leave comments down below if you have some. Also, if you subscribe, you'll know every time we post a new video. I enjoy learning with you, I enjoy teaching with you, and together we can take over the world.